A squadron of 10 starships is journeying towards Mars, devoid of human presence but harboring a crew of 120 dormant robots. Their mission: to construct and establish a colony on Mars, prepping the planet for the arrival of humans. Their first responsibility is to build structures for their protection and energy source, while braving Martian dust storms, solar flares, potential malfunctions, and chilling Martian nights and winters. Once a protective settlement is secured, the robot's next task is to build a colony for future human inhabitants. The robotic crew has an estimated timeline of 2 years and 2 months to accomplish this colossal task, an era referred to as the Robotic Age of Mars. You are watching Adventures in Space. Upon touchdown, the starships sound an alarm, marking the start of the mission. From each ship, 10 drones fly out, buzzing like bees leaving a hive. These drones inspect the starcraft for any damage sustained during the landing. Meanwhile, within the starship, the robots are performing an internal system check, establishing connections between themselves, Starlink satellites, and the rovers already on Mars. They create the inaugural hive mind on the red planet. Given the considerable communication delay between Earth and Mars, the robots are designed to function independently. The time it takes to transmit data ranges from 3 to 21 minutes, depending on the alignment of the two planets. On Earth, the human overseers adjust their schedules to align with Mars's time, essentially working in sync with the robotic team. The robots then prepare to unload the cargo. The construction of the robots' habitat begins. The robots initiate their work at 5:30 a.m. Martian time, when the sun begins to warm the planet's surface. They have until 6:30 p.m. before the freezing Martian night, with temperatures dropping to negative 94 degrees Fahrenheit, sweeps in. The robots are capable of enduring these freezing nights, but it demands more power to maintain the warmth of their hardware and avoid faults due to the low temperature. The robots transport the cargo from the spacecraft to the proposed base site, located 1.2 miles from the landing site. This location is selected considering future landings in the vicinity, taking into account the dust and rocks that would be stirred up during landing. As the robots move across the Martian terrain, their tracks create the first makeshift roadway on the planet. The foundation for the robot habitat is laid. A massive container at the heart of the empty construction site unfolds to reveal the beginning of the robot's assembly work. The first structure is a storage garage, supervised by the aerial drones acting as surveyors and providing accurate coordinates to the builder robots. These drones also assist in laying cables across the structure. This storage garage provides shelter for the robots and secures the sensitive cargo. It safeguards against the harsh Martian nights, winter, and dust storms. The garage also houses robots dedicated to cleaning Martian dust from their builder counterparts. Simultaneously, other robots keep expanding the structure, converting it into a fully automated robot workshop, affectionately called Home Base. In a different part of the base, robots are setting up the solar field. They bring the solar panels to life, which themselves are robots capable of tracking and following the sun's movements. This smart tracking allows for optimal power generation and efficient dust cleaning. The solar panels are equipped with a robotic attachment that can detect when dust accumulation inhibits their function and subsequently clean it. As the freezing Martian night descends, the smaller robots retreat to the shelter of home base, while their larger, well-insulated counterparts, equipped with floodlights, work tirelessly, installing the robotic solar panels. The robotic team on Mars is divided into two categories: simple robots and advanced AI machines. The simple robots follow basic instructions, performing tasks such as loading and unloading materials. The AI robots, on the other hand, have a higher level of autonomy, making decisions and operating with versatile tool attachments. An incoming solar flare, taking 22 hours to reach Mars, prompts the robot builders into sleep mode. Some encounter software corruption, which necessitates a system reboot. Ground-based satellites are installed to form the beginning of a satellite field, and a small dome is erected to house the internal communication equipment. Control of communication shifts from the spacecraft to this newly built ground station. This station, connecting with the Mars Starlink satellites, oversees the robots and monitors Martian weather, dust storms, and nearby asteroids from the asteroid belt. Commencing a transmission from Mars, our metal pioneers relay their vital information to the heart of their operations, the dome. Every bit of data accumulated is stored in a massive server, ready to be beamed back to Earth. Future plans for this communications hub include coordinating the movements of every inbound and outbound starship. Meanwhile, the fruits of their labor, electrical energy produced by the solar field, is being directed towards their central workstation, dubbed Home Base. A multitude of batteries store this crucial power. There are batteries allocated for the dome facilities, and others to power the bots themselves. Our industrious robots employ an efficient system of interchangeable batteries to keep the wheels of progress turning without interruption. As the Martian outpost begins to resemble a miniature town, drones continuously map out the site, plotting roads and paths in the digital sphere. The robots, each contributing to their part, have successfully established a network for transit among the rapidly proliferating structures. Within the dome sheltering home base, three emergency response rovers stand by, awaiting any distress signals from their robotic brethren. Carrying an assortment of spare parts, they are equipped to perform in-field repairs on malfunctioning robots, assist any bots stuck in the rugged terrain, and even carry out maintenance on their solar-powered counterparts that may have been dusted over. Elsewhere, an emergency dome is swiftly erected by the diligent robots. This light, temporary shelter allows them to continue their relentless efforts, even amid minor dust storms. Meanwhile, another monumental project is nearing completion, the biodome. This ecological wonder will house an array of plant life, the sugars from which will be harvested and mixed with Martian soil to produce a 3D printing material, fundamental to their future construction projects. Plants that had been maturing aboard the starships are transferred to this dome, under the careful watch of the terrestrial controllers and Mars-bound bots. With the completion of the first phase, the robotic settlement is a fully operational, self-sustaining entity. Now, they begin preparations for the arrival of their human compatriots, starting with the construction of vital life support systems. While the robots are content with their Martian home, their human counterparts will need a way to return, necessitating the production of rocket fuel on Mars itself. As part of their duties, mining bots are dispatched to designated resource areas away from home base. Their mission: to gather and assess the purity of ice samples, the crucial component for life support and fuel production. Back at base, the building blocks for refineries are being unloaded, the carbon capture towers rise, and an electrolysis facility is assembled, preparing to extract hydrogen and oxygen from the ice water. A Sabatier reactor stands ready to combine CO2 with hydrogen to generate methane, the rocket fuel, and life-sustaining oxygen. Under the cover of the Martian night, the ice mining droids tirelessly ferry back and forth between the ice fields and the base. A delivery of a flexible pipeline by a cargo starship is planned for the future to streamline this process. Meanwhile, construction preparations for the human habitats are underway. The ground is flattened and debris is cleared, while large harvesters are busy extracting soil near the base. Back in the newly constructed 3D printing depot, the soil is cleansed of perchlorate, mixed with plant-derived glue, and converted into 3D printing filament. This filament will be fed into the habitat printer, a massive robotic arm that sets itself into the ground and methodically constructs the habitats. The 3D printed habitats, constructed in a circular pattern, form a unique cave system providing radiation shielding for future human inhabitants. The inner habitat modules, which will provide pressurized and oxygenated living spaces, will be expanded closer to the human arrival. Inside the biodome, the robots have already initiated the next phase, growing food for human consumption. They utilize a vertical farming system to maximize the yield within the limited space. A robotic arm system meticulously plants seeds on trays and monitors each plant for nutrient uptake and health status. Once deemed pure, the produce is stored, resulting in the first Martian pantry. Away from the base, near the starships, robots work on creating landing pads. By flattening and melting the Martian soil, they create wide, flat surfaces, thus reducing the potential for dust and rock kickback during future landings. Human habitats are then pressurized and oxygenated, equipped with water and waste management systems. They house miniature robots that act as the brain of the structure, constantly monitoring the habitat and its surroundings. Three humanoid robots are activated. These Martian pioneers serve as the testing ground for the EVA suits, spacesuit, and rover airlocks that will be used by future human explorers. Now, as the time for the arrival of the first human visitors draws near, the robots take some time to roam the Martian landscape freely, but they know the peace won't last. The humans, weakened from the zero-gravity journey, will soon navigate the perils of Mars: the radiation, the dangerous dust, the bone-chilling nights. The robots will watch their human counterparts, and after a year, they will bid them farewell as they return to Earth, leaving the robots behind to welcome the next wave of human explorers. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed my futuristic vision of the Martian future, please give this video a like and subscribe to the channel. Besides the future, we do updates on everything aerospace industry related and much more. As always, this was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you at the next one.